Our story is set in Bethlehem, Judea. Caesar Augustus has decreed that everyone should return to the town of their birth to be counted and taxed. The overworked manager and employees of the overcrowded Bethlehem Inn and Spa are trying to cope with the rush of people. So join us as we listen to the manager and the desk clerk discussing their problems. Action.
I've never seen this place so full. I don't know how we're going to handle all of these people.
Oh, I know what you mean, man. I've been banging out Ingrid's designs all morning long from a request from a group called 8 to Triple Club. You know, no 8 red people, man, coming in here talking about they need 3 king size, man. I tell them, man, hold up. Because we got a tour group called the May Guys coming to town. I'm saying May Guys. Man, that I'm going, I don't have no place for it. That's what I told them. Then I tell them, you know, them rock groups, man, are so dishonorable and so they're so disrespectful to our guests. This crowd is nothing here.
Tell me about it.
But they sound good. They sound good.
Man, tell me about it. And what about those Roman soldiers? Carousel and Cranor? Man, I had nothing but complaints of them about our complimentary fixed-on breakfast. You think goat cheese, wool, muscle balls wasn't good enough for the likes of them?
I guess better than. Hey. I know we're busy, but our parking attendant, he just walked off the job. And you know, we got VIP, and all of them have right-hand drive camels.
And we don't know how to travel.
Man, I never could have hired my wife's nephew for a job. So, can you get that Gardner, what's his name? He works for that rich merchant who lives on one hill. And he's from the southern part of the empire and does things backwards already, just as those southerners always do. He should be happy to earn a few extra shekels.
I take care of that right now, boss.
What? Oh, and don't forget to have him wipe off his smelly boots before he arrives. He walks around spreading manure on the plants all day, and that odor falls him like a cloud.
Do we take Orient Express?
What is the problem?
It's that Jan's birthday. All she wants to do is strut around in her leotard and complain. She says if we don't give her what she wants, she'll develop her own exercise program and go into competition with our spa.
Well, you better go ahead at this time. Ain't no use to make an excuse to make her enemies, because she can be pretty ugly.
You're telling me she thinks she's a queen of sheep.
That's what I'm putting. Oh, now what?
I set that crack in on room 6. My pa smelled the lamb chops. He liked the order. He sent it back. He told the bellman his lamb chop wasn't smothered. It was beating to death, and he could see the bruises. Through the woo, I don't have to take that.
Now. Remember, he is our guest. Besides, he sees a second cousin.
Right, you well. But one more time, I'm out here like more without it either.
I've got a problem.
So what is in there? Come on, let me hear.
A group from the World Tour meeting, and I'm now dying. Transportation for a tour of the area. I contacted Dromedaries, or us, and not a single camel is available. One hump or two?
Ha! I'm Dunky Dill. I overheard the conversation. I'm the self-Judah Dunky Dill. I overheard the conversation. And if they're not right, I'll make them right. Free. And here's my address.
Thanks, Dave. My man. No problem, son. I got a Lulu for you. I mean, real Lulu. I don't know. But, we got a man out back with a pregnant, a extremely pregnant wife. And she's pregnant. And he got no money.
What in the world are we going to do? And they want a room.
Tell them there's no room in here.
No, there is.
You go back and tell them there's no room in his hand. And I feel sorry for him.
Yeah.
But if I could not squeeze another person in here, if he was the Messiah himself, he'd come and see
me. Okay. I'll do it.
Oh, damn it, that little drummer pointed down.